Are you on a mission to change the destiny of Bosnia and Herzegovina?
Yes. Yes, I believe I am. And among others who are the first generation leaders in this country, and if we don't do it, if we don't take the responsibility and that call seriously to be the history makers and the changers, really, because we have a history and it's gonna repeat if we don't change it. And what's gonna repeat? It's the war, it's the bloodshed, it's the wounds and brokenness and poverty that we have all lived through. And we would like to see something different.
Because truly this is a divided nation.
Oh yes, you have East Sarajevo, you have another Sarajevo.
I mean, there may not be lines of demarcation, whether it says, well, this is where Serbs or Croats or Muslims live. There's no sign, but clearly in every city from Sarajevo to Srebrenica to Banja Luka to Mostar, people live according to their ethnicities. People live according to their religion.
Yes, I mean, in Sarajevo you have East Sarajevo and then you have another Sarajevo. You have East Mostar, you have West Mostar. Even in schools, there's a term that's called two schools under one roof. And nobody knows in the whole wide world what does that mean, except in Bosnia. And what that means is that the children, the same age, go into the same building, just because they are from a different ethnic groups, they learn completely different things. They are completely different two schools. They have two principals, two secretaries, two programs. They are learning different history. They are learning different geography. They are taught that they are different. And when I see that, I see that in few years to come, that's an army ready to fight another war.
So how on earth do you find hope? I mean, how do you find hope in the midst of so much division, so much hatred in a place like this?
It's gonna take what usually takes to change one individual person's life. It's gonna take Jesus. It's gonna take that redemption power that's in his blood that can reconcile us to God and also nation to nation. But we know, you know, what seems impossible to men, it's possible to God. It's gonna take God. Nothing less and nothing more.
What is it like to be part of the first generation of Christians in a country? I mean, the United States, Great Britain, some of these other countries that have a rich history of Christianity, hundreds of years, yet you guys are less than 20 years.
It is true. We are the first generation. We are like, I don't know, around 500 to 700 believers, depends. But that's still the most that has ever been. So when we look in that perspective, we are thankful to God. But the field is huge. And the need is huge. It's really like Joshua and his generation entering the promised land when God told them, this is the way you have never walked before. I'm gonna walk before you. And truly is that way. It's only God walking before us. We have to be mothers and fathers in Christ that we don't have. We need to learn how to be that to those coming behind us. And it's difficult, because we don't have examples before us.
And in some ways, the church, the small church, is a microcosm of the hope that could potentially come to Bosnia, where Serbs and Croats and Muslims are worshiping together and in unity.
Oh yeah, that's the only place. Even in the midst of the war, when the church was bombed and there were bullets flying in the church, inside that very church, there were ethnic groups, three ethnic groups, worshiping the same God, while their ethnic groups outside those walls, spiritual and physical walls, were killing each other. And that's amazing. And based on that I see it's possible. And I stand on that. And I believe it can happen in individual lives and in this country at large. If God doesn't intervene, if we don't see the move of God in the years to come, we will see another war.
Do you ever wish that you went somewhere else, that maybe God calls you somewhere else, and perhaps you can even be more effective?
Honestly, no. I love this place. God gave me such a love for this place. There is no other place for me to live. Is it difficult? Yes. Every day it's difficult. Regardless how long, regardless how little the results are, I am called to be part of what God is doing in this place. Is it in sowing? It's going to be in sowing. Is it maybe that I will never see any fruits of what I'm doing now? That's okay. Just the fact that I am part of that puzzle, of that painting that God is painting in this place, in this country, for the future generations, that's it.
The reality, Vanya, is that the potential for the next 10, 15 years of not witnessing or seeing the fruits of your labor, that's there, that's real.
But are we driven by numbers? Do we decide where do we go or don't go because of the numbers and results? Do we decide how effective we are only by the numbers? Some people in the past, great Christian names, they didn't see any numbers. But they were faithful in what God called them to do. And that's what I'm driven by the call that God has placed on my life, by the part, by the role that He wants Vanya to play, and the talents that He has placed in my hands, whether it's 1, 3, 5, or 10, He is going to ask me what I have done with those, not with something that He didn't give to me, but what I have been given. And my only hope, that one day when I face Him, He will say, good and faithful servant. It may not be numbers, but according to His economy, according to His call, that's what I'm driven by.
You know, people will say, I mean, come on, how can there be only 500 Christians in this entire country, home to about 4 million people? You know, you look at places like in Africa, in Asia, China, Latin America, where thousands of people are coming to Christ, but here you only have 500.
It's not easy. We would wish it that it's different. We prayed a lot. We pray a lot. We cry out to God a lot because Jesus Christ and the kingdom of God in this country, as we pray, may your kingdom come and your will to be done in this place, is our only hope, not just for eternity, but to live this earthly life, because we may have another war. So we need Jesus to change our reality. We pray, we cry out, but it's really one by one. And as it says, the heaven rejoices over one, and we do too. We do too.
You know, we say in the West, it's about reaching one person, but in reality, we reach more, 100, 2,000 people. But in Bosnia, you're literally, I mean, you are literally trying to reach one person at a time because of just how difficult it is to share the gospel of Jesus Christ here in Bosnia.
Yes, it's really one by one. Yeah, it's a celebration.
Amen.
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 And for us who don't see much, the leaders who are sowing, and we don't see many people get saved, when we see that, it's like, great, let's go for another day. Let's do another run. Let's do another circle. Let's continue running. I can't say that it's not encouragement to see numbers. There are such a long periods of time when you don't see much, and you get discouraged. And it's only God who is keeping you going. So when we do see results, when we do see those three people getting baptized, it's amazing. The joy, the excitement, It's amazing.
George Thomas, CBN News, Sarajevo, Bosnia.